Hello, I'm Arachne, and welcome to my review of Final Fantasy III. That's how you actually read Roman numerals. So, let me address this game setting. Final Fantasy III is set on an unnamed planet, but in this game there are ancients, a species of people that have a very special connection to the planet nature and its crystals. Seems legit. And if I wanna get real dumb, I could reveal that the world of Final Fantasy X is named Spira, and this is without a name. But this might be connected to Final Fantasy VII because of the presence of ancients? That's it. It's official. This is the first game in a trilogy and it's called Final Fantasy III. Okay, enough of that nonsense. The story of this game is really simple actually. There's a real idiot thinking he could cover the world in a darkness called Dark Cloud and control it. Wait, Cloud? Weren't we just talking about Final Fantasy VII? No, stop it, come on. I mean, this Dark Cloud doesn't know how to interact with the game world, so they use this crazy angry person, like Zande, as a vessel. That's the stupid human I was talking about before. That's it. There's a lot more encounters during your travels and plot developments, but they don't change the incipit of the objective that's set up in the first 5 minutes. Free the crystals, defeat Zanden, and then Dark Cloud. That remains the same from start to finish. Nothing of all that happens really changes any of it. Gameplay is the usual role-playing fare, just more magic than in the first game. What's really interesting here is the class system. Every class has unique abilities and they're gonna come useful against various enemies and bosses, especially in the first half of the game. To unlock them, you need to liberate a crystal from the influence of Dark Cloud, and I found that a very rewarding mechanic. Having major plot advancements tied to having the possibility to expand your gameplay options is a really ambitious idea for NES, but it works. They somehow made it work. There's also unique equipment for each class that only them can wear and use in battle. Unless you find the mighty secret class of the ninja. They can use all equipment, oh well, it's a secret. I'm not going to tell you how to unlock it. Okay, let's get to the real amazing stuff. This game has 4 world maps. One of those being underwater, because you use a fucking submarine. There's also a normal ship and 2 airships. All 4 of those have their unique music that accompany boarding them and using them. It's not done so the developers could flex. All 4 maps have purpose and serve to reach areas that make sense in the dialogue. Oh, I almost forgot to tell you. You can find places by talking to people, apart from a couple of secret areas, but that's fine. They are secret after all. I actually hate when games have secrets but they are all marked. Then they are not secret. Secrets need to be not spoken or seen before reaching them. So yeah, this game has a good balance of exploration and hand-holding. Since I can't touch upon it, let's delve into the music of this game. I consider this Nobuo Uematsu's first actual masterpiece. He was the one just flexing on all of us, not the developers. He really did a soundtrack of a game for NES with more than 50 compositions. And it's glorious. There's just so many good pieces from this game that actually inspired Uematsu for other entries in the series like Final Fantasy IV or IX with his own music. Sorry, I meant the 9th. The Romans get pissy if you don't remind people of it at least 2 times a year. In conclusion, it's a fantastically constructed game that suffers from the same problem that every game on the RPG side suffered on NES. Grinding. Oof. At least the encounter rate is not stupid bad like the Lagrange point. Also on NES, a game I will not review. I tried it for an hour and I spent 40 minutes into battles, and those can spawn intra battles between battles. Say what? Nah. Aside from that, I enjoyed my time with Final Fantasy III more than I expected, also thanks to the constant change in locations and the variety of them. This game is not one of my absolute favorites on the console, but I get real close to that. Enough to deserve a 9 out of 10. There's a lot more I could talk about, but I'll let you discover the rest. I said everything I had a strong opinion on anyway. Feel free to discuss this video, the review and the channel in the comment section below. Hope you have fun on here. If you wanna keep up with what I do, follow me on Twitter @ArachneRetro. See ya at the next review. Bye bye!